So Commerce City is a very diverse city as it relates to housing stock. Really what you have to think of in Commerce City, or if someone talks to you about Commerce City as an investment area, is ask them, are you talking about old Commerce City or are you talking about new Commerce City? Because Commerce City geographically is very large and it has some old areas of town that are vastly different than some of the newer areas of town. So it's a very bifurcated area that way, and you need to know what part of the town you're looking at from an investor's standpoint. But here's a couple pros and cons of considering to invest in the Commerce City area as a landlord or as a real estate investor. Number one, it is close to DIA, and that has been that has been the primary benefit of DIA to Commerce City. It's all the new stuff that has popped up in Commerce City is primarily because of DIA. Everything along the Reunion area on 104th Avenue, all that new housing stock out there, that is a big driver of people that commute regularly, regular travelers to DIA. So Commerce City has benefited greatly by the placement of Denver International Airport close to Commerce City. Second benefit is amenities. And the reason we have a question mark is, again, old or new. In old Commerce City area, there's not many amenities there. You're not gonna find a whole lot. Now, in the newer part of Commerce City, they are adding amenities. It's been way slower than it should have been, in my opinion. It's taken them way too long to develop some of these amenities, but they are now coming along slowly but surely on these things. But if they continue on, that'll be a plus. It's not an overabundance of amenities, but they keep saying they're going to be adding amenities. So if they do, that will be a plus, but they're not there yet. Third benefit is that the cap rate, and the cap rate is your investment rate of return on your money, but the cap rate is higher than in some other areas. Why? Because it's a little bit more of a risky area as compared to some other cities. So you're going to get a little more bang for your buck if you choose to invest in Commerce City as compared to, say, downtown Denver area. Now, there are a couple negatives to invest in Commerce City as well. Number one, it does have a higher than average crime rate. And tenants look at crime rates when they're thinking about moving their family into an area. So simply statistically speaking, because it has a higher than average crime rate, there's not going to be quite as much draw into the single family market, for example, of rentals. Now, the rental market is still extremely strong, but as compared to some of the other cities, this still has to be taken into consideration as a negative. Second, the city, as I said earlier, the city covers a very diverse geographic area and a diverse quality of housing. So there are some of the lower income properties that you'll find for rent in the Denver area overall are located in Commerce City. Some of the higher end properties you find for rent are also in Commerce City. So it's very, very diverse. And this is not necessarily a bad thing, but it's not, when you hear the word Commerce City, different people think different things based upon their view of it. Are they thinking high end? Are they thinking low end? So it's a diverse economic base that way. Negative number three, the quality of the education is not great as compared to some of the other neighboring and Colorado cities. Their education system is rated lower, which again means tenants looking to rent are going to view this as a negative for wanting to potentially move into the area to bring their families into the area. So we give Commerce City a B. It's a solid B. If you're going to be buying in Commerce City, look in the Reunion area, look in some of those neighborhoods on 104th Avenue. As that continues to develop more and more out there, we think that's a good long-term play as investors in the Commerce City market.